A team that experienced success, exceeded all expectations. From winning 3 games a year to contending for a state championship. Through the years of Lynx football, one thing stayed the same.
Family.
Tough.
Resilient.
Hungry.
Determined.
Rising up to the challenge.
This is Lynx football.
Think what's happened in the weight room in the off season the last couple years, and the number of kids who have bought in and who have made that commitment in the off season to be better in season is one of the big reasons why we're at where we are right now.
Good. Okay. Good. Good. There you go, Eric.
Yeah, Jimmy! Go!
Well, I mean, obviously, us as a team, we really wanted to make it one more game than last year.
And the rest of you, remember, have to be blocking like Oz. We got to be sprinting.
I'd say our main goal is just at least to make it to the next game, which we have done now.
It's not like a quick tug.
Just to make it past the point we made it last year, getting to the championship is probably the biggest goal we had. And consistently working out and stuff in the offseason, I'd say was probably our biggest goal.
You had a lot of guys buy into the aspect of the offseason.
Yeah, for sure. We definitely had a lot of people consistently going every day during the summer that you could. And
this week is no different than any other week, and that's done intentionally.
Just like throughout the week, practices will probably be the same. I think the difference will probably just be like the energy.
Last time we're going to practice on this field. Make it your best one. Make it your best one. Come on.
Just like the sentimentality of it, because like it's the end, like, and we know it's the end because there's nothing after this. It's like, yet like yesterday we were running and it was like, hey guys, we gotta give it all because this is our last Monday. This is our last Monday conditioning.
But the big change for all of us is, especially the seniors, like this is probably the last football game that a lot of us are gonna play. And I think we're all ready to just pour our hearts into it.
Let's go, Mo! Okay!
Come on! End up well.
Kind of like that relief that like we've been working all season to get here, and now we're finally here. So everyone's kind of not like relaxed, but more like, we're ready.
We get some sort of arrow, some sort of guy hooking up, some sort of guy running a flag or a go or something.
Just the fact that it's all settling in and it's actually like happening to us, and that like we've grown up playing since what, 6th, 7th grade, and this has kind of been our dream, and that's what we're achieving now. So that's kind of a cool thing to just go through.
Last few practices of my high school career, I guess. Probably last times I wear the pads without the jersey, for sure.
It's vibey, you know? Last practice ever, baby.
All right. That is not our norm. That is not us, right? Some were right, some were not.
Back, man.
We're going to go after. God gives you opportunity, go get it.
Amen.
Let's pray.
I'm feeling great, dude. It's championship game day.
God is really good in all this. There's a lot of cool things that come out of sports programs. This is something that these kids get to do that I told them the other day. When you're 10 year union, when you're 20 year union, you're 30 union, when you're bald and fat, you're going to remember this. Okay? And so now we're just going for it.
The thought process that you're going to be thinking before the game, just like the nervous energy in the locker room.
Just the experience and knowing that we're going to have this for the rest of our lives.
Make sure you are dialed in.
Probably being there at the championship game for like the first time in 20-something years, I'd say that's pretty big.
And how hype it's gonna be before game.
Probably just get on the field and start running around, get the whole see the whole environment, and just take it all in.
At this time, we direct your attention to the middle of the field, where our officials will be meeting with today's captains and conducting the coin toss.
During warm-ups, watching them, when they get their name called and they go down the 40, right?
Number 13, Jackson Cordell. Number 15, Bryce Bowman. Number 16, Treyon Shooten. Number 25, Jude Belkin. Number 41, Easton Strebler. Number 54, Will Faber. Number 55, Davis Gatterman. foul. Roughing the kicker. 15-yard penalty. First down. Third play. Your score, Lenny Christian 0, Henry Royal 0. Third and 10.
Thank you. Tell you what, our kids hung and they hung, and we were really proud of them. And then we thought we were going to get it there at the end, but then they got us on that last second pass. But no shame. Love our kids. Proud of our kids. Community came out. It was a wonderful day for Linden.
We've been together for a long time, from seventh grade to now, and we've put a lot of blood, sweat, and tears into it, and I think, yeah, I love these guys, and these are my brothers.
Just being with them specifically, that's what's made football so great so far anyway. Even like win or lose, like with them, I wouldn't do it with anyone else.
We've all gotten so close over the last couple of years, no matter if you play or not, you know, you're a part of this team and you're a part of this family.
You know, I told them on Monday, I told them before the game here, I told them right here when they were here, I said, hey, we love you. There's absolutely nothing you could do to make us not love you anymore. All you can really ask as a coach is they give every bit of effort they did, and there was not any kid who did not give his very best today. And so, proud of them, real proud of them.
Really, no matter what the outcome, I'll just enjoy the time I've had with these boys, and been such a journey, and glad we've made it this far, and God has a plan, we'll use it.
I'd do anything for my guys out there, right? It's not, when you're out there, it's not you and 10 other guys. It's one team. And that's kind of how I feel about them on and off the field, right? I'd do anything for them.
It's been unique. It's been a really cool opportunity to look back on younger kids that look up to us and just have this opportunity to be an influence on and off the field. Because when you see the kids, the younger kids in the hallways, when we go over to the elementary school or middle school, and just be able to be kind of a light on and off the field.
I mean, after every practice, we go 1-2-3 family, and it's true. We're like brothers to each other. Just the friendships that we, and the bonds that we make in the locker room and on the bus rides home, those are the things that I'll probably remember the most.
It's been different than everything, like every sport I've played in like my life. It's just like the coach, even the coaches, and everyone just kind of comes together. Bus rides are a lot more entertaining because everyone just gets along, and it doesn't really matter who you're talking to on the sideline, who you're sitting next to on the bus. Everyone just kind of clicks, and it's been a lot of fun.
I think just being able to play for a state championship in high school, like not very many people get that opportunity, and just to be able to do it with these guys is just the world to me.
I think the team as a whole has been like, has shown me what like a really great team can be when everyone works hard, everyone trusts each other. But like also the coaches have really invest a ton of time into preparation and stuff.
And you can tell kind of in the way they approach the game and the way they approach the off season, the way they approach game week, the way they approach games, every way it plays out, they love the game.
One thing that we always keep coming back to, one word that we always use the most would be family.
Determined.
Family.
One word I would use to describe Lynx football, especially this year, would be hungry.
Family.
Rising up to the challenge.
If I was to describe Lynx football, especially the senior class, I would describe us as tough.
One word that comes to mind for me is blessed. We're just blessed with like amazing athletes to play the game, and also our coaches and support staff to help us get where we're at.
Give the cliche answer, family.
I think they're going to look back at it. They're going to be pretty proud of what they've accomplished. And I know I'm proud of them. And I told them, there's nothing they could do to keep me from loving them. So I love them and very proud to be a part of this program.
Family on three. 1, 2, 3.
Family.
My name is Trajan Scouten, and this is Lynx Football.
Preston Vanderveen, and this is Lynx Football.
I am Lou Timmer, and this is Lynx Football.
Hello, I'm Jackson, and this is Lynx Football.
I'm Levi Van Weerdhuizen, this is Lynx Football.
Dan Kamek, this is Lynx Football.
Coach John Van Holzen, Lynx Football.
Coach J. Paul, Lynx Football.
I'm Mitch Faber, and this is Lynx Football.
Put your hand right
2 years ago, we were garbage. Now we're fire.
This is Lynx Football.